Sin Fronteras, Western New York.
This is for you, mis hermanas y hermanos.
Where you can voice your thoughts on how we live, work, and play in Western New York.
Buffalo is in a renaissance, and Latinos are a huge part of our city's growth.
We want to hear your voice.
Llámame 837-1112.
Or hit us up on Facebook 24-7, 7 days a week. Talk with Samantha and Michelle, Sin Fronteras, Western New York, every Friday at 1 on WUFO 1080 AM.
¡Wepa!
Presented by the Hispanic Heritage Council of Western New York, dedicated to preserving the history of Hispanics in Western New York for future generations. Sponsored by Goya. Si es Goya, tiene que ser bueno.
One, you're on.
You're listening to Sin Fronteras, West New York at 1. Good afternoon, I'm Samantha Martinez.
And I'm Michelle Agosto.
If faced with a difficult decision, where would you turn to for help? Today we'll talk to Brenda Montenez and Stephanie Valenzuela of Jewish Family Services. Learn how this organization can help local families with free and confidential services.
And Sin Fronteras Western New York will bring you the latest events happening in our community as we celebrate the Bills in their playoffs this weekend.
And the number of hurricanes-related deaths in Puerto Rico may be underreported by the hundreds. Sin Fronteras West New York is bringing you the very latest. Y número tres in the top Billboard Latino esta semana. Están escuchando La Modelo Ozuna featuring Cardi B. Sin Fronteras West New York at 1 starts right now.
Yo quiero hacerte tantas cosas sin enamorarte. Quiero que te sientas cómoda si vamos aparte.
Así como tú quieras, te hago el amor y pa' mí. Modélame, bebé, en ropa interior y de pensar que yo contigo quiero estar. Quiero hacerte tantas cosas sin enamorarte. Quiero que te sientas cómoda si vamos aparte.
Así como tú quieras, te hago el amor y pa' mí. Modélame, bebé, en ropa interior y de pensar que yo contigo quiero estar.
Sin Fronteras West New York is brought to you by our sponsor, Goya Foods. Si es Goya, tiene que ser bueno. The time is 1:05. Sin Fronteras West New York is bringing you continuing coverage of the recovery efforts in Puerto Rico. The number of hurricane-related deaths in Puerto Rico may be underreported by the hundreds. That's why Puerto Rico's Governor Ricardo Rosselló is calling on a special task force to investigate. The group is expected to report its findings, including any revised numbers from the last 90 days. The executive order includes creating and coordinating a process in conjunction with health, forensic, and demographic registries to review the deaths of following Hurricane Maria and whether they are related to the effects of the devastating storm. The issue of the death count has been a topic of concern. Currently, the official death toll caused by Hurricane Maria is 64. However, recent estimates conducted by Puerto Rico Center for Investigative Journalism and the New York Times suggest that the real number may be more than 1,000. President Trump is pushing for an action on immigration while pressing for his wall on the southern border. On Thursday, he announced that any legislation to address the residency status of Dreamers must be put on hold until the border wall was secured. Trump is laying down a red line as Congress gears up for yet another round of fights to fund the government. He also demanded that future legislation further restricts visa overstays, the so-called chain migration, and the end of the visa lottery. The Dreamer situation has remained in limbo since the Justice Administration announced last fall that it would end the Obama-era program that allowed young adults who came to the U.S. illegally as children to remain in the country. Trump kicked the issue to Congress in September while promising to resolve the DACA issue with heart and compassion. Displaced Puerto Ricans living in Jacksonville will get a sigh of relief this weekend. That's thanks to the owner of the Jacksonville Jaguars, Shahid Khan, who has donated 1,000 tickets to Sunday's game against the Buffalo Bills to refugees and Puerto Rican Hurricane Maria survivors who have now made Jacksonville their new home. The team's foundation is also providing transportation, souvenirs, and food vouchers during the game. Khan says he hopes that the event will give the guests a well-deserved break from what can be severe challenges in their daily lives. The Jaguars are also providing tickets to local servicemen through their partnership with the United Service Organizations. Coming up next, we'll talk to Brenda Montenez and Stephanie Valenzuela of Jewish Family Services. Learn how this organization can help local families with free and confidential services. And now a message from our sponsors.
Tito, no es correcto que hagas después de tomar tu néctar Goya.
Marita, niña, Benito.
Los néctares Goya son ricos, ricos, naturales y nutritivos, con más frutas que los demás. Tamarindo, pera, mango y muchos más. Saboréalos y un de tu boca surgirá. Néctares Goya, más fruta, más sabor.
Goya tiene que ser bueno.
Well, welcome back. This is Michelle Agosto, and we're so happy to have with us today from the Jewish Family Services, Brenda Montenez and Stephanie Valenzuela, who's here to talk a little bit about what the Jewish Family Services does for the community of Buffalo. So I don't know who'd like to step up first, but can you describe a little bit about the services offered through the Jewish Family Services? Stephanie?
Sure. Okay. Yes, thank you. So Jewish Family Services is a non-for-profit organization. We work with individuals from infants to the elderly. We provide services such as counseling, care coordination, refugee resettlement, parenting, exactly. And to make one thing clear, no, you do not have to be Jewish to qualify
That's
for the
first
services.
Question.
Yes, all the time. I'm not Jewish. I'm like, it doesn't matter.
Right.
We'll help anybody.
Is it that they followed like Jewish values, or is it why does the name stay with the organization? Can you tell a little bit about that?
I know it was funded by the Jewish, mm-hmm. And we are actually right next to the synagogue.
Okay.
So yeah.
So they're connected.
Right.
That's awesome.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Why do some of the health barriers? We want to talk about some of the services that we give to Buffalo and our citizens in Buffalo. So I'm sure you figured out with all the things that you offered some of the health issues that we have to kind of focus on. So are there some barriers that you find that are hard to manage, or things that you want to focus on that will help the community? Is there something that you find that's really vital, your needs are really vital for the community?
Well, some of the barriers that we're finding is the language barrier.
Mm.
There's a lot of doctor's offices that don't provide translation or interpretation, so most of our clients don't want to go to the doctors because they can't communicate. Some doctor's offices, not all, provide the language line, but the other thing with that is the dialect.
Okay.
It's not the same. So we've had complaints where our clients don't understand, even if they're speaking their own language. Mm-hmm. Another barrier is transportation. That's a real big one. Mm-hmm. So if you don't have transportation, you're not going to make it to your appointments. And so even if there's medical transportation available, but not many people know about it or know that they can use that service. Mm. So the other thing is lack of knowledge. Mm. Not everyone knows what their services, what services are out there or resources that they can tap into.
This is Samantha from Sin Frontera, West New York at 1. Brenda, I'm so excited to have you on the show.
Thank you.
We actually had her daughter on the show a few months
yes.
back who won Miss Teen Buffalo.
Yeah. So, Young Miss Buffalo. Yes.
Young Miss Buffalo.
Yes.
So we have the whole family now. So in regards to the West Side, what collaboration have you done on the West Side?
So on the West Side, we have a lot of clients that live in the West Side area. We have clients that are in a GAP program, and those are people that are homebound, and so the services are brought to them, so counseling is brought to them. And then we're also working on a mental health satellite that's going to be located on Niagara Street.
So if you can circle back to, you said there was transportation that people don't know about. Can you explain what that is, how it works, and how someone can use those services?
Well, there's the medical transportation, and normally if you have Medicaid, you're able to have transportation, as long as it's for a medical reason. The barrier that I'm finding, though, is that if you're going to Social Security, you're not going to get a ride.
Mm.
But it has to be for a medical reason.
And it has to be doctor approved.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
So if you could walk us through the process of how someone can get that service. Do they just simply call a number?
They call a 1-800 number. Mm-hmm. And then they give their information, whether it's a social security, like the last four numbers of their social security, or their SIN number from their Medicaid card, and then tell them the information. You know, what time, the date, and where they're going, the reason why.
Great. So we'll be posting that number later on our Facebook after the show.
So, Brenda, you talked a little bit about the language lines, mm-hmm. and that part of communication. And Stephanie, you talked about being a service for our new settlers, our new Americans, and newcomers.
Yes.
So, how do you reach out to those people who probably need the services the most? You know, in our Latino community, of course, but there's so many newcomers to this city. How do you make the effort to reach out to them so that the language isn't a barrier or the transportation is a barrier? How does Jewish Family Services reach out to those people?
We have weekly outreaches.
Okay.
Our outreach coordinator is Jackie. If you're listening, hi, Jackie. So, yes, we go to different apartment buildings, and they'll host us, especially like at senior residences. And we'll be at the common area, and then we have our poster, we have our sign-up sheet, and we can like sign you up right away. So we definitely host these different like get-togethers,
right?
And promote JFS.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And so you have like satellites? Is that satellites or is it just
like
you
outreach.
Find? A,
okay, it's more like outreach. Okay. So on a weekly basis, we go out and just sit there. She
it's like
sits
a crew
there.
Of you kind of
yeah.
go out.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
A couple of us go and then just sit there and give them information.
Okay.
So
you guys offer a lot of services, and these services are free for the community, confidential, right?
Yes.
Compassionate, correct?
Correct.
So from these services that you offer parenting services, mental health services. If you can talk a little bit more about each one and how people might be able to receive these services. Tell me about the parenting services.
All the services we have are based on the client need. So by calling JFS, you tell them what it is you need, and they link you.
Mm-hmm.
For us, we do the care coordination. So we work more with like getting the people to appointments, making sure they have primary care physicians. If they need different resources, whether it's housing, transportation, or even for social services, we can link them, we can help them, and just, you know, be there for them. And in my case, I speak Spanish, so I tend to work with more Latinos, and so we're able to provide that translation for them. And
just to piggyback off what you said, for the parenting, we do work with kids, so sometimes CPS does get involved, for example. So we are able to offer them the parenting services at the location. And we also have English classes.
That's great.
All of that.
Mm-hmm. That's a lot. That's a lot of services.
Yes.
A lot of services. So how busy is your place? Like, I can imagine just it being constant, like the numbers with all the services you offer and all the different people that we have. It must be a bustling place to be.
Yeah, definitely. We constantly have people in and out. So you'll see people from all over the world.
Right.
You know.
Right. And we're on the road a lot.
Are you?
Because we do home visits.
Right.
We don't just bring them over to the office. You don't have to meet us at the office. We come out to you.
We do.
Where are you located exactly?
We're on 70 Barker Street.
70 Barker.
Between Delaware and Linwood.
Okay. And it's an open door. People can go in. Is that something that they can do? Or is it always by appointment? Because some people don't know about Jewish Family Services.
Right,
I'm actually learning a lot just listening to you. So is it open door? Can they call?
They usually prefer to make an appointment.
Okay. Do you have a phone number that maybe you'd want to share?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Brenda, I think you took it down.
Yeah, so the number is 716-883-1914.
And they can ask for someone who speaks Spanish?
Yes.
Okay, and then they can just tell you what they need, and then you send them to that person or that.
Right.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So transportation, we mentioned earlier, is a big concern, barrier for a lot of the people receiving the services. How can they request an in-home meeting with you?
They can give me a call. My number is 716-328-3962.
And you go right to their house.
Right. Well, our boss, Sarah Uckin, mm-hmm. she says She's available to speak to whoever.
Okay.
It doesn't always mean that we can service you, but if we can help you find the services, we're willing to speak to whoever. So don't hesitate to call.
So working with the Latino community, what type of health barriers do you find specifically? Not just health barriers, but just barriers as a whole that relates to the Latino community, since you work so closely with them?
Not trying to get any type of health care. And the stigma of mental health.
Yes.
So it's just, you know, it's going to their homes, it's encouraging them that, you know, it's not scary to find out what's wrong with you. And then the sooner you find out, the easier it is. We can help you find a doctor or, you know, why you're feeling sick. Things like that.
Would you like to talk about this in Spanish for a little bit so that our Spanish listeners might be able to take use of this information?
Okay.
Seguro.
Seguro.
So estamos hablando que en la comunidad latina a veces hay estigma de la salud mental, ¿verdad?
Sí.
También hay, a veces tienen miedo en cuidarse, ¿verdad? La mamá cuida de todo el mundo, que es sus hijos, la familia entera, pero ella es última, ¿no?
Siempre.
Si me puede contar un poco de su experiencia y por qué es tan importante que la mujer, la mamá de la familia, ¿verdad? Que se cuide y servicios que puedes buscar en su organización.
Bueno, con la ayuda de nosotros, pues, entonces, podemos conseguirle un doctor o los servicios que necesita. Muchos latinos no les gustan ir a consejería porque piensan que eso lo hace loco. Ahora soy loca o yo no soy loca, pero este poquito de tiempo de ir a hablar con una persona que uno no te conoce y todo es confidencial, uno se siente mejor y así puede seguir hacia adelante con su familia. La cabeza siempre que tiene que estar bien. Y eso es algo que no se ve mucho en la comunidad, ¿no? Nosotras siempre nos ponemos última en vez de ponernos primero.
Entonces, esa persona que está en búsqueda de este tratamiento para la salud mental, como estamos hablando ahorita en inglés, que quizás no tiene este carro, ¿en cómo puede llegar?
Bueno, puede llamar, hay un número de 1-800 que lo vamos a poner después en Facebook, pero puede llamar y también tienen una opción para español.
¿Para que para que el doctor sea que hable español o para, yo estoy hablando para recibir transportación?
Ok, so lo que uno hace es llama a esa línea y le das la información o los últimos 4 números de su seguro social o su información de seguro, de Medicaid, y entonces ellos le dan la información de dónde vas, para dónde vas, qué día, la fecha, y ellos vienen y te recogen a tu casa, te llevan a la cita y te recogen de la cita y te llevan a tu casa.
Y si la mujer tiene niños, ¿hay sitio para cuidar a los niños si tienes que traerlos con ellos o...?
En sí, eso depende de la oficina del doctor. Pero ellos también te preguntan que si vas a venir solo o tienes a alguien con usted. Entonces ahí, pues, si tiene los hijos, se los puede llevar en la guagua, en el carro también.
So I'm wondering, you talk about transportation and you said it's all free, right? Everything's free for everyone who wants the services. I'm wondering, you talked about mental health. And so I'm wondering, maybe Stephanie, you can jump in. Have you seen an uptick on some of the clients that you have regarding Hurricane Maria? We have a lot of transplants now. Have you seen some of our sisters and brothers from Puerto Rico who have come over because of Hurricane Maria kind of walk into your doors and ask for help?
Yes, they're still trickling in. Mm-hmm. We are the Spanish speaking care coordinators. We're actually gonna start getting rid of our English speaking so we can make room for them.
Right.
So we're still waiting for them. But we do have people who have been affected. A lot of people are very devastated. They just did a coat collection at JFS. So hundreds of coats were brought in for all the people that were coming in. And we also have other donations.
We've kind of worked off of referrals. Mm-hmm. So when we were doing the coat drive, we also asked some of our present clients, hey, do you have any family that's coming in, or do you know of a family, or maybe where you work? I called a couple of workfare sites through the Department of Social Services. I called a couple of their sites and asked them if they had new clients that came, because of the hurricane. And they gave me a couple of referrals, and then and we've been, you know, communicating with them and offering our services. Like, hey, we can help you. We can find you, you know, a doctor, make sure you're getting health insurance and whatever else you need.
Yeah, we actually, on our show last month, we had a psychotherapist talk about a lot of Puerto Ricans suffering from post-traumatic stress as they come here, and there's been an uptake in therapy because of that. Is there a specific therapist that you guys can refer Puerto Ricans to, or Latinos, that is bilingual and aware of the culture?
I mean, right now I always refer to Lakeshore, because they're the ones that have like Latino or Spanish speaking counselors. Other than that, I'm not very familiar.
Right.
Yep.
So let's bring this up a bit. Let's get some happiness at the end. So I know you offer all sorts of events to mm-hmm. the community. Is there something coming up that you'd like to share and kind of get some people involved?
Well, you have an info, Brenda?
I think it's over here.
I think it's about love, right?
It is okay. About love. Loving yourself.
Yes.
Actually,
it's called Love Yourself.
That's wonderful. Okay.
Yes. It's on Delavan and Greater.
Okay.
At the Delavan and Greater Community Center. And our representative, Jackie, will be there doing outreach from 8:30 to 4:30. They're going to offer breast cancer screening and some makeovers.
Oh, I love makeovers.
That's February 12th.
February 12th from 8:30 to 4:30. Where again?
Exactly? Delavan and Greater Community Center.
All right. So if you love yourself, Jackie will love you too.
Yes.
And she will give you a makeover. Well, ladies, thank you so much for being here. I appreciate your time,
thank
sharing
you
all the important
us.
Things that you do
thank
at the Jewish
you.
Family
thank you.
Services. And we hope to see you again soon.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
When we come back, Sin Fronteras West New York brings you the very latest happening this week in your area. And now a word from our sponsor.
Well, Happy New Year, mi gente. It's nice to have you all back for 2018. There's still time to be part of the historic renaming of the Niagara Branch Public Library. The Hispanic Heritage Council of Western New York is asking you, our listeners and community members, to help decide which name of an important and significant Hispanic Latino Latina will grace the walls of our West Side Public Library. Forms are available at www.hispanicheritagewny.org or send in your recommendations via email to info@hispanicheritagewny.org or mail them to P.O. Box 361, Buffalo, New York, 14201. This Saturday, Dr. Caban's dedication to School 76, Herman Badillo, they were going to dedicate him and the auditorium under his name, will be postponed Saturday, January 6th, postponed. Do not go there. It will be closed. The new date has not been decided yet, but it will come up, and when it does, we'll make sure to put it on the Hispanic Heritage Council website, we'll make sure to put it on the Sin Fronteras Facebook page, and we'll make sure to announce it on the radio. He is an incredible educator and community member. We want to make sure that Dr. Caban's name is recognized, and we will do that shortly at School 76. Lastly, I would like to congratulate my co-host Samantha here, who has just gotten engaged. We can all clap.
Yay!
Happy New Year. And we're so happy for Samantha and her fiance Shane, SNS. It's a nice title. I've missed you these last few weeks, so I'm glad that we're together and to celebrate such wonderful news for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It was a surprise, but a pleasant surprise.
So that's a good wepa right there. Everybody, wepa! So we would just want to make sure that we also celebrate the bills. I know the engagement's huge, but the bills is bigger. For me, I mean, I've been engaged, I've been married, it's all the same. You know? But the Buffalo Bills, we're so excited about that playoffs. Are you ladies excited?
Yes, I am. I'm a big fan.
I know. I dressed like this professionally today in my Bills gear. So I'm really excited. So I'm glad you're here to celebrate that,
yes.
too. It's a good day.
That deserves a
weapon. It does.
Weapon.
Thanks for joining us for Sin Fronteras West New York every Friday at 1. Remember, you can always catch Sin Fronteras West New York online and on our Facebook page whenever you want, all the time, 24/7.
And for Samantha and Shane, our last song for the day has everything to do with them and nothing to do with me. It's called A Promise by Usher featuring Romero Santos. And go Bills y adios.
Love you, baby.
He perdido el balance por tu amor. En tus manos yo caí. Tienes control sobre mí.
Oh wait! All right, we're going. Thank you, everybody, for listening. Happy New Year! Go Bills! Go Bills!
Go Bills!
Go Bills! Go Bills!
Go Bills!
Go Bills. Go Bills. Go Bills. Kevin!
Go Bills!
Yes! All right. Yes. See you soon.
Keeps pumping, trying to swim.